Guys, welcome back to Cyberbikes. I'm Felipe, your host, as always, and I'm here to talk about brakes, brake pads, and brake system. So I'm gonna do a short video just to explain to you why our e-bikes are better than our competitors' bikes in terms of brake system. Why? If we start with the brake pads here on the up left, we're gonna see that the brake pad constitute of a metal base plate and a friction material. Usually they are welded or the friction material is glued to the metal base plate. Here on the front view, we see the friction material and the base plate around it. Okay, our e-bikes, the brakes last about 5,000 kilometers between brake pad change, while our competitors last only 1,000 kilometers. We have been conducting many tests here in the workshop to come with these numbers. So what happens here? This is our brake pad compound, and this is the original brake pad compound found in most bikes. We have a better compound, which is not too hard to cause any damage to the disc, and it's not too soft that you have to replace it very often. One important thing to notice is that this brake pad here, can you see these dots? These dots are the welding or the glue that connect the friction material to the metal base plate. You can see we have the dots here as well. Okay. The person who was riding these brake pads wore them till the friction material disappears completely and metal is touching the disc brake. You should never let your bike reach this condition here. Okay, this is beyond maintenance and is repair. So instead of replacing just the brake pads, now you have to also replace the disc. Okay, so this was the disc that was on the bike with these brake pads. So moving on, it's important that the brake pads here, so this is the base plate, this is the friction material, and in red is the disc. It's very important that the brake pads touch the entire race of the disc. So the same diameter that the disc has should be exactly the same of the top area of the brake pads. If you are missing a few millimeters here of the disc, probably you're gonna create a step here on the top part of the disc brake, and that can be very dangerous because the other brake pad here on the right will actually touch that step first before it touches the disc. So you lose all stopping power. So here at Cyberbikes, we are very concerned about it, and our bikes, they're beautifully made to have the disc finishing exactly at the top end of the brake pad. All right. A healthy disc will have more than 1.5 millimeters thickness. So if your disc brake is below 1.5 millimeters thickness, you have to use this tool here, okay? Micrometer, unlock it, bam, bam, bam. Okay, and you have to measure the race of the disc like this, something like this. Here, yeah, like this. You have to lock it using this clamp. And then you can measure the thickness here. Okay, can I measure this? Let's see if you guys can see. So we are way below, we are 1.26 millimeters thickness, which is something that is not ideal, and you're gonna lose all stopping power. You know, the disc starts flexing and can be very dangerous. So continuing, on a healthy disc, which is above 1.5 millimeters thickness, the material, the friction material of the brake pad, this blue thing here, it starts to accumulate on the surface of the disc. So if you change brake pad compound after, you know, if you change brake pads and they are of different compound, you won't reach maximum stopping power straight away. You will have to let the new brake pad compound accumulate the material on the surface of the disc. I'm talking like micro meter technology, you know, like, and after there's some sort of accumulation of material on the surface of the disc is when you start reaching maximum stopping power. On a damaged disc, the disc gets concave, and so you lose the contact ability of the brake pad with the disc, and more. In this case here, the material of the base plate started to penetrate the disc and grooving the disc even more, reducing the thickness of the disc even more, and reducing your ability to stop the bike in time and securely. Okay, so if there is an accident about to happen, when your brake pads are in this condition, you are not able to stop and avoid the crash. So what you have to do, replace the brake pads in time. That's the number one. If you wait till you start listening to metal noise, it might be too late. You might be pushing material off the base plate to the surface of the disc. The second thing to do is measure your disc with the micrometer. This is the tool here. Great tool. So measure the thickness of the disc brake. Don't use a vernier caliper because it doesn't work. It has to be a micrometer measuring the race of the disc brake. Then, if your brake pads went metal with metal, we call metal with metal when there's no friction material anymore and the base plate is touching the race of the disc. If that's the condition, you have to replace the disc and replace the brake pads. And just one last tip is, people always come to me and say, I want Shimano parts. Okay, so this is Shimano, the other disc is Shimano. I don't recommend Shimano for e-bikes. They are great for normal bikes, normal push bikes, performance push bikes. They are awesome. But in terms of e-bikes, they are too light and they are less thick than other brands. I'm a big fan of Tektro for disc brakes for e-bikes other than Shimano. So if you have a normal mountain bike, you pedal just with your legs, that's cool, go with Shimano. If you have an e-bike, go with Tektro. All right, I hope you guys learned something in this video. There is so much to talk about brakes. I won't be able to cover it here right now, but if you have any questions, I'm gonna reply them in the comments. And through the questions, you know, I'm gonna record other videos talking about brakes. All right, so I hope to see you guys soon. And don't forget to leave your thumbs up, subscribe, share, and leave your comments below. Thank you very much. Cheers.